99th episode of Survivor NSFW. It's going through a couple games and congratulations. Matt is producing in Cincinnati. He's watching, he's waiting. If you are a Patreon, you will see him. But I am live here. I have winner of Survivor Ghost Island, Wendell Holland.
Thank you, Craig.
I have the most beautiful of the Beauty Tribe, Brice. What's up, Brice? He's popping. And I mentioned to you guys earlier, this is the 99th episode of Survivor NSFW. And when I think 99, I think 66, because 66% of men lose their hair by the age of 35. They get your loss is too long. It's easier to keep the hair you have than replace it with the hair you've lost. Is that the hairline slowly starting to move backwards? Any bald spots yet? How will you feel a year from now if it's not business as usual up there? I ask you, do you want a bald spot to pop up, or do you want to do something about it first? Will your hairline turn you to receive it, or do you want to do something about it first? Why do you guys turn to beer solutions or do nothing when they can turn medicine to science? Forhims.com is a one-stop shop for hair loss, skincare, and sexual wellness for men. Hims connects you with real doctors and other great solutions to treat hair loss. Well-known generic equivalents to name-brand prescriptions to help you keep your hair. No snake oil pills or gas station kind of supplements. Prescription solutions backed by science. No waiting room, no awkward doctor visits. Save hours by going to Forhims.com. Answer a few questions, doctor will review and prescribe and products to the directly to your door. Order now. Listeners get a trial month of Hims for $5 right now while supplies last. See website for the details of the information. This will cost hundreds if you want the doctor or pharmacy. Go to forhims.com/fair. That's forhims.com/fair. Forhims.com/fair. What's up? The episode tonight was crazy. We're in Baltimore. We had a full house.
This is nuts.
We start the episode with the edge of extinction. We have Eric Halfman is second guessing his decision to stay on the island. Would you second guess anything, Wendell and Brice?
If I get a second, if I get
booked, I don't know if I can vote it out. Let's vote Wendell out tonight. All right,
if I was voted out and had a second opportunity to get back in the game and play for $1 million, play for Survivor. I wouldn't second guess that. I'd stay on it. I'd do whatever I got. However, they're big stickers. They're down to the bare minimum. Don't have much. And definitely difficult out there.
Do you think there's any chance of winning the game if you are here now? Cast criticism for quitting, but I mean, is there any chance Eric has of winning the game? Can you be like, I got no chance. I get what you're saying, but I don't. These people don't like me. They're not going to like me in the next 10 days. Screw it.
He has a difficult road ahead. He has to get through Joey Amazing.
Yeah.
Aubrey. Who else is
that? Like Reem.
Yeah, it wouldn't be easy for him, but still, he's a firefighter.
As long as there's a chance, yeah, if you're a firefighter, you don't have a choice but to stay out. Or you're not on the 60-guy calendar.
Correct.
Yes. Yeah. So Brice, would you get out of day 23, do you stay in the game, or do you just say screw it?
Day 23, I'm Keith Sole. That should be a pound.
You're watching. Even if you put out Chris was there. Wait,
I'm back.
You're back. So you're not going Bon Rosa. You're not going to TV. You're the only mask that's being lifted is the one who's looking at Chris.
Catch me under the wood.
All right, so we get back we have decision of the ranks. You know, there's people that were left out last week. Common surprise, or the blind side, and people are like, where are everyone's loyalties? Everyone's making pitches. Who do you feel sorry for right now? Going into this community, or who are you liking?
I kind of felt like, all the ways they were like, whom I really like. I'm really liking Rick and Devin. I kind of felt like last season came on hot and heavy because I felt like you're coming off of Extinction Island. So it's like either you're going to try to play the background or you need to come on and let Wardell know who's the daddy of the island. And so I kind of feel like where Rick is coming from. And now currently he's the pilot of my shit. I mean, as long as it's not a Boeing 767, I'll let you know Rick drive
my plane.
Who would I feel sorry for?
Yeah.
Other than myself. You know what? I felt a little sorry for Ron Clark this episode. And I'll tell you why.
Yes.
In the game of Survivor, power does a funny thing.
Power absolutely corrupts. We saw you on Ghost Island, one of the nicest survivors, one of the friendliest survivors, one of the kindest editors in the history of Survivor. You had one bad try.
I had a very
bad try. I'm like, what happened to my boy? You gave me a game director.
Yes.
But you had a bad one.
Yeah. So when you're in a leadership role or when you're calling the shots, it's a scary place to be. Because people are looking at you. You got a lot of eyes on you. You got a lot of people that want to start you. And in Ron's last week, they got his right hand out of it. So he had some humble eyes.
I think it's all shenanigans. I think it's all theatrical. I think it's the quote unquote, low budget puppet master. There's only one. We all know that. But the other puppet master, like I think he was putting on a show, and I think you give that guy a little bit of power in the next week or two episodes from now. He's sitting back to the same arrogant guy that I love last episode.
I hear you. I definitely hear you, but like, I don't know. I felt bad for my guy.
So, fast forward to the immunity challenge, and we've seen this one before, but David participated in kind of the connect and made it to the end. What do you think of this challenge? This is kind of one of the lamer challenges. Gavin did add a new win to that resume.
Yes, he did. He looked real good today. And I mean, when I traveled, they went into it with a plan. The line took a shot. Other than that, he looked strong in the challenge. In dealing with people, he looked good. He wasn't making any, he wasn't planning for it. So I wanted to look out for it, man.
Definitely someone to look out for. Post community challenge. We have everyone, everyone's scattered, going to little groups, and you have some of the comments saying that Kelly went for it, now's the time. I think Kelly is the most dangerous person remaining in the game. Whereas David purposely won immunity because he's like, now's the time to pull the trigger on David. David equally as dangerous, if not secretly more.
Agreed.
And Kevin's wishes are kind of falling on deaf ears, and he's sulking a little bit. So, but it's not sulking in a way that everyone's pointing at him, pointing Kevin's over there, moving basin. They're just like, hey, you know, that's the smart play.
Yeah, he suggested David, and they kind of shot him down. And he didn't make any fuss about it. He kind of walked off, yeah. But then he heard him say something to him. I thought it was democracy, not a dictatorship or something like that. That's the way you got to do it.
Yeah.
If you hear something that is not in line with your plan, you don't flinch.
You got to roll the dice. As long as they hear you, we're going to say it to you as Trump. And
you're
and,
right.
You and, oh, man, he's the best. And I can go all day without David Swine.
I love
him. Great. I hope you guys get it off. But you fast forward 3 days later, then it's like, okay, you got your plan last time, let's do my plan this time. And if that's not cool, then we need to reevaluate this whole what an alliance is. I think Gavin put on the chin pretty solidly and pretty well. I think he's gonna get on.
But then can we fast forward to Final Travel for a second?
Please.
Then it seems like he got his shot at Julia, right? Because I think he wrote her name down.
He did write her name down.
So it's like,
but tribal group. Okay, so also, you know, we have the deal between, you know, David and Rick Devins, you know, the sheer custody of the hidden guy. There was a little trouble here, guys, and everything, you know, worked out in the end. If you were in a situation like that, Wendell, with someone other than your brother from another mother, Dominic, how would you handle a scenario like that? It's real easy with the best interest, which it seemed as though Devins and David had, but that all splintered last week, and it felt as though they were playing two totally separate games versus what they were initially doing.
Yeah. Did we see many conversations between them about the item today?
Yeah.
Right. So I guess cooler heads prevail of them. They're just like, look, we have what we have this tool.
Yeah.
The two of us, we could, you know, just pull two souvenirs and we go home with that one and make a smart move. So they did what they should have done. They used it.
I would make the pitch, you know, let's remember the good times. Like, hey, you know, my last couple of days were a little shaky. Remember back to when we used to hold hands and sing Kumbaya. Let's go back to that.
Yeah, that's it.
And then, you know, once I was played, then, you know, you can send me home or, you know, preferably I'll send you home.
Well, at least let's use it the smart way while we have it.
Yeah. Price agrees. All right, so we do get to tribal council. This is a 30-minute, it's a 1-hour episode, 30 minutes of which is tribal council. This has got to be the first time in the history of Survivor in which we've gotten 30 minutes of tribal. And even in the Outcast twist, I don't remember being that long.
Yeah, I think this is the
first time. We went to a commercial break in the middle of the drive. So, my first takeaway from the crazy tribal, I don't know if it's the craziest tribal of all time. Maybe not. Well, that's up for debate. But we'll go back and be one of those epic moments in a few years. But we're watching, and my first takeaway is getting to what you mentioned earlier, that you know that power and you know, that absolute power absolutely corrupts. It's happened, you know, throughout history time and in your careers. It's on a three basis survivor season after season. And we saw one of the nicest survivors ever. You, we saw it with you. We saw it with you tonight with a little bit of power, and I can. It was not a good look.
It wasn't. I love Julia.
She's the leader. I mean, like I see her social media rants and I agree with a lot of them. Yeah. So but you know, you got a lot of airtime tonight, girl.
That's the problem.
When
I'm looking at
Brice,
early on, she got along with that.
Yeah.
And I looked at Brice and I was like, man, fighting her content. Randomly, she hasn't gotten a lot of
attention,
yeah. So I was kind of scared
for her
early on.
Yep. Yeah. And so, no, I get to think Devin's a passage between the fact that he got sent to enter Extinction, but then came back. But what they're not factoring in is that guy came back as a hero. Like, everyone, like the people still in the game, other than a couple people with these brazen egos that don't see it, they're not catching everyone. Everyone's just, wow, that was a heroic thing that he did. And then the people consisting of the jury, they're like, that was a very heroic thing that he did. That I wish I did, but I'm not holding against him.
Yeah. And if you heard that, you see him, like, walk out, he doesn't look like the hero or anything like that. But,
I don't think it comes off as bad if you don't have Julia Julie crying. I think with Julie crying.
What is she crying for? Because she's not in control? Because she's used to being in control? And like the Survivor now, you're in a microcosm. So now you get to experience what other people feel like? Or in real life? Like, you know, so cry me a river another day. I'm not hiding. That doesn't look like I love her, watching her, but like that doesn't like with me, and it doesn't like me. What more resonates with me is the Julia Carter that is actually like sitting up and saying, sit down, war dog. Like, these are the things that like kind of like are the same. Now we gotta get Julia out. Like, because prior to now, I don't feel like Julia was the target.
Yeah, no. No, same sort of war dog.
That's all made her the hero. Oh,
right. That's just not good.
I guess I'll play the devil then. For me, I think that in Game of Survivor, they're looking for any reason to argue out. So if you say something like "shut up, war dog," to war dog Game 5, then he has a reason to vote. And if you say, I don't know, I found myself during my season out of play with Laurel, and Laurel is this super accomplished woman. She went to Yale. Volleyball player, she's a state champ swimmer, and all these things. And she found people during my season, like talking down to her, talking to her like she's amazing. And she's the smartest person by far on the island. And I looked at her and I was like, oh, you and I were sitting here at the end. But right now, we gotta kind of
hold it in.
We gotta hold it in right now, whatever. Because I guarantee you and I will sit at the end.
But who's Julia's winner? Julia, that's the right one. So I feel like, you know, that's why it resonates so much with me. It's like, anywhere in life that I go, I'm always a Julia Carter. I'm always by myself. I'm always having a thing for myself. So it's like, you never know when to actually speak up for yourself. So maybe that's why I connect so much with Julia. And in regards of, like, you know, going into tribal with a tight line, and then it kind of, like, just explodes. Like, you're saying, like...
I don't think it explodes if you're going to say that. I've only been
one tribal guy. I'm talking from one experience.
I play a very passionate game. However, like Richard Hatch, my first ever Hatch in the All Star finale. Like, I walked up to Hatch, I said, "Hi, you know, Hatch, Jonny Fairplay," and I put my hand out for 16. He refused to shake my hand, and I was like, "Excuse me, because I don't respect the way you play the game." So I, you know, affectionately threw a drink at him and walked away. And I later met Hat. We played Family Feud together. We made it to the final round and won together. We had Hat with the other final two. And he just seen the back, like, you know, he playing off the handle and stuff. And I was like, "Look, man." Like, you know, I didn't know the game was Survivor prior to being cast. Once I was cast, I went back and studied the game. You know, I played I kind of feel a loophole in the way that has to play. Like, you know, like, these people bother you. You just have to, you know, bottle it up and let it go. I bottled it up, but, like, after tribal, I have one day before thinking, the tribal's every 3 days. So that next morning after tribal, if I have a problem with you, I will let you know then. And I will unleash everything I got in me then. So I understand where Julia was, but I think tomorrow morning is when Julia expresses her frustration.
When Julie,
Rick Devins, and everyone else.
So in other words, you make sure you last through that evening.
Yes.
Get through. Make sure you get back to your camp.
Because I don't think you are getting up if Julia doesn't unleash right there. I think she opened that can of worms, calling out Rick Devin. Because Rick Devin, her upsetting Rick Devins made Rick Devins make that vocal play.
I will agree with that. Like, her outburst absolutely put a target on her head. Like, without a doubt. Like, they were just like, if you call me out, well, I'm going to vote for it. But what I was speaking on is, like, I can 100% relate to where she's coming from in the aspect of, like, shut up, word up. Like, you know what I mean? So, but absolutely, like, girl, you should just been like, but
That's it. What were you doing all day?
Didn't it start when Wentworth asked Julia?
Yeah, right.
So it was like, what's going on? Julia said something to him. Yo, we're good. We're going to stick to the plan. And Devin was like, oh, I'm not in this plan.
Wait, but once again, that was that power and ego. We were going, hey, we got a plan that's going to be great. And it's just like, okay. And she's looking over at Aurora. She's like, you're spilling the beans. You're spilling the beans.
Well, I mean, I'm not really info. So, what really is
Price about to spill the tea?
So, what really I feel like the MVP player of this tonight's episode is Brick. And let me just break it down for you. So, you know, I don't really like to talk about resume. But if you were talking about Gavin saying that he built a winner's list, I think equally as much as Rick Evans was. I think it happened. Like, I want to talk about like JJ Evans from this time. Like, I don't know why that just takes me there, but
Rick. James!
Yeah. Alma. No.
I get up. There's a couple of people. Like,
but I really feel that because I felt like Rick was clickbaiting Julia. Because, like, first of all, you already know you're on the bottom. So, like, her confirming that you're on the bottom is like, okay, what is she doing? But she's now calling her out on it. And I feel like that is kind of like, man, you are really like playing the game, Rick. And not only are you playing the game, I'm sorry, I'm sorry. I felt like him kind of like exploding that moment, that pivotal moment. I kind of like exploded into what we now have as Survivor, or you call it Survivor 45.
Why is it Survivor 45?
Let it sink.
Okay.
Thank you for that, Bryce.
We most of the viewing public, and Julia with a new decision. She's going to the edge of the missing season. Yeah. So, all right. So, how do we rate this episode? Was this a great episode? 30-minute tribal? Is that excusable when it's that great?
These things have gotten better than that. So this, I think, is the best
episode. Okay.
I think that this is by far the best episode of the season.
Yeah. All right. Let's start. So I'm into it. And next week, join Matt Bischoff. He's commandeering the mothership in Cincinnati for us. Next week, we will do our 100th episode. That is crazy. It's an unbelievable milestone. If you'd like to catch the video version of this, which is you get all the craziness, you can find that at patreon.com/SurvivorNSFW. That is the best way to support the podcast. Also, get a shirt at jonnyfairplay.com. And I will be in Nashville, Tennessee, April 24th, not next Wednesday, but following Wednesday. And I will be at Zany's Comedy Club, one of the most amazing comedy clubs on the planet. Some of the greatest comedians ever have graced that stage. I'll be joined by Tosh Tour from SWP and Survivor Caramoan.
Tosh is going to be there.
In Nashville. You can
Bryce might be there too. I'm gonna have Piggy from Millennials versus Gen X. Wendell might be there, so we never know. But for that one, it's the special Twitter URL. Go to SurvivorAfterHours.com. That is SurvivorAfterHours.com. I have, I believe I have a Survivor OG from the first season joining the national team. So once again, go to SurvivorAfterHours.com. We'll do that. And finally, May 1st. I will be in Santa Monica, California, about the Key West. Get tickets for that on TikTok.com. I'll be joined by Rhino, Jay from Good Action, and many more. It's going to be a great, great time. So for that, go to TikTok.com. Yeah, this buddy, I'm glad I got to look at the beard. and until next time. All right, SurvivorAfterHours.com, SurvivorChicks.com, and Patreon.com. Thank you so much. Thank you, Baltimore. This is awesome. This is you guys made this so much fun, and the party's just begun. Thank you.